Let's try to start understanding what is the difference between get and post method. We have seen some of the difference, and one of those difference was that in the get method, the form parameters are visible in the browser URL bar, right? Whereas in the post method, the form parameters are not visible in the browser URL bar. So we'll see, we'll try to understand other differences. What are the other differences in get and post? Then we will try to see, just have a quick look on what are the other, you know, HTTP methods available, right? So when I talk about the HTTP method, typically get and post are the most used HTTP method. There are other HTTP methods as well. And when I say HTTP method, that means the specification is given by the HTTP protocol, right? The specification is given by the HTTP protocol. What you see in the HTML file, in the form action and method is equal to get or post or something else, right? And the corresponding, the do get and the do post method in the server, which is on the server side, are meant to support the HTTP specification of the methods. Okay. But the specification is in the protocol itself. Okay. Now, these are some of the differences between the get and the post methods. Get method data is sent in the URL, so it is exposed. We have seen this. Post method data is sent in the body of the HTTP, so it is safe for the credential. ठीक है? क्या मतलब हुआ इसका? Get method data is sent in the URL, so it is exposed. Post method data is sent in the body of the HTTP. HTTP request की बात कर रहा हूँ मैं. I'm talking about the HTTP request, right? ठीक है. Get is exposed, post is not exposed. I'm saying that post is something which goes in the body of the HTTP. ठीक है. Then that means get, the form parameters of the get goes as the header of the HTTP protocol. Let's go a slide next and let's try a typical example of how the minimal get and the post request could be seen or could be observed, right? So whatever the browser sends to the server is a HTTP request. Now just have a look at this. This is the instance of the get request. This is the instance of the post request. Okay? You can assume that HTTP itself is just like an envelope. Okay? And then in that envelope there are two things. I mean two separate papers, just for the, you know, comparison I'm telling this. So one paper is the head or the header, and the other paper has got the body, right? So there are two parts in that envelope, there are two parts, right? So you can see in the get, when you use the get method, when you request through the get method, request a resource through the get method, you can see everything goes through as a part of the header. Okay, see the URL get, then the name of the application, that is contest route, select, for example, select beer trade, test.jsp is the name of the resource. It's a JSP resource, just like a servlet resource, right? Color is equal to dark, and test is equal to multi, and then HTTP 1.1. So these are the form parameters. This is the protocol version, right? So this is the URL part that goes along with the request. Then you see it contains many other parts. This whole thing is the header part of the HTTP get. It contains host, that means for which, you know, server actually the resource is hosting. And then user agent, Mozilla 5.0, Macintosh system, and you can see. So what is this? Sometimes it happens that you request for a page and the page says that your browser is not compatible, upgrade to a higher version. and or it says your operating system is probably, it tells about your machine that you are holding Windows machine or whatever machine, right? So how does they get all this information? Basically, the browser which sends the information, browser is something which acts as a user agent, agent to the user, right? So this is the information which is basically sent to the server, and it's part of the header. Just like you can extract all the parameter information from the request, you can also extract all the header information separately from the request object. ठीक है? जैसे request dot get parameter करते हैं, we call the get parameter method on the request object to get the parameter. Similarly, you have got the method to get the header information individually. ठीक है? On the request object itself, because it's coming along with the request. See, then accept. This means what the browser is capable of accepting. Normally, the modern browsers are capable of accepting a lot variety of, you know, formats and, you know, things. But this is just an example, so you can see it can accept text slash XML, XML file, XML page, which is written in the form of text, right? Application slash XML, application slash XHTML, and so on, HTML, and so on, right? Image, videos. What is the language it can accept? Encoding, character set, and then keep alive with the session. Timeout, okay, for which the connection is going to be kept alive. For example, if you requested a resource and then sometime it says, it keeps on, you know, showing that it's in a wait state, and then it says that timeout. No response from the server. So because this keep alive time has expired. Similarly, if you can see this instance of a post request. So these are the requests, right? HTTP get and the post request. You can see everything what you have seen in the get request, the header part is also available in the post request. The only difference that you can see is now this form parameters, they are being passed as the part of the body. They are being passed as the part of the body of the HTTP request. So now they are separate from header. That is why they are hidden. Okay? That's the basically the motivation to keep it, you know, hidden. And there are other reasons as well. You will see that. ठीक है कि why you know the post request sends the form parameter as a part of the body and not as the header. ठीक है, ये क्लियर हो गया. Similarly, we can have a look what we get as a response, as a HTTP response back from the server. So this is a typical, you know, capture of what we receive. I told you there were three important things about the request and the response in the last class, right? So what is the three important thing about the response? Status code. So 200 okay means the request is served and the response is returned, everything is okay. So a status code as well as a textual version of the status code also comes along with it, right? Then content type, text slash HTML. This is also called as the MIME type, right? And what method that we have used in the servlet to set this content type? Tell me. What is the method that we have used to set this? This is the response, right? This is the response. So while we were writing on the response object in the servlet, we have used certain method to set this MIME type or the content type. Set content type, and that was called on the which object? On the response object, because this is the response, right? So response dot set content type. You can remember which methods are part of which object, right? So content type is again an important thing. There are several other things like cookies. We will try to understand what are cookies in the later classes. Content length is the length of the actual content, which is the part of the body. Okay. Date, time, and then connection. Because it's a single request and response cycle, it shows the connection is closed. That's it. Okay. And then the third important thing was the content itself. So here you can see in the body of the HTTP response, we have got HTML as a response. It could be a PDF file, it could be an audio video file, it could be a Word file, it could be almost anything which is supported as a MIME type, right? See, you have come late, right? Little late. You are little late. I just started this discussion telling that all these methods, whether get, post, or the other methods of HTTP that you will see, they are the part of HTTP specification. So they were described by the HTTP protocol. If you see the documentation of HTTP 1.1, right? You will see all these methods and what they mean actually. Now, what you do is in your index.html page, you say form action and then method is equal to get or post. You specify over there in the HTML file, right? Similarly, you also have got a supporting method on the server side in the servlet, which says if the request is get from the HTML or the browser, you have got a doGet method to serve it. Otherwise, there is a problem, right? If you do not have the doGet method, there is a problem, right? If the request is coming as a post, then there is again a supporting method called as doPost, right? Because it has requested for post. Now do post operation of the whatever the content is required by the post method. So you have got a doPost method accordingly. So these two technologies, both HTML, which is a client side technology, and servlet, which is a server side technology, they are supporting HTTP. Right? Now your question is whether the method is part of, right? No. Tell me. You have to tell me. It's coming from where? HTTP is a specification, right? It is coming from, not server side, from the client side, the browser. आप HTML में mention कर रहे हो कि आपको गेट से करना है काम या पोस्ट से कराना है, क्या रिसोर्स चाहिए, गेट से चाहिए या पोस्ट से चाहिए? They are mentioning in the HTML, right? So basically HTML is interpreted, although it's lying on the server side in the project, which is in the container, and that's lying on the server side, but it's being interpreted on the client side. When you press the submit button, it's coming from the client, right? It's coming from the client. So the client has specified as a part of the request that which method should be followed. So that means if you want to get the method, you have to use request object. ठीक है, क्लैरिटी हो गई ना, ये चीज समझ में आ रही है? ओके, लेट्स गो बैक टू द डिफरेंसेस ऑफ द गेट एंड द पोस्ट मेथड. सो फर्स्ट डिफरेंस इज वेरी मच क्लियर. गेट मेथड डाटा इज सेंड इन द यूआरएल, सो इट इज एक्सपोज, दैट मीन इट इज आल्सो सेंड इन द हेडर पार्ट ऑफ द एचटीटीपी रिक्वेस्ट. ठीक है, पोस्ट मेथड डाटा इज सेंड इन द बॉडी ऑफ द एचटीटीपी रिक्वेस्ट, सो इट इज सेफ फॉर क्रेडेंशियल. सो इफ यू आर यूजिंग क्रेडेंशियल्स, you do not want the form parameters, whatever you have filled in the form, to be exposed. You have to use post, right, and not get. Okay, there is a number of character restrictions in the URL, so get has a trouble. There is no restriction on the content size in the body of the HTTP, so post is good to go here. This is again a reason why the content, why the parameters goes as a part of the body of the post request, because of course the header is a small thing, right? The body is something which is a bigger thing. It doesn't have a limit, right? The header has got limit in everything, right? Okay, so if you use get, then not only just the form parameters are exposed, but also you cannot exceed the specified limits in the number of characters. ठीक है, क्लियर है? वेयर एज व्हेन यू यूज पोस्ट एवरीथिंग गोज एज अ पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी, सो वट एवर इज द लेंथ ऑफ द कंटेंट इट डजंट मैटर, इट्स गोइंग इनसाइड द बॉडी. ठीक है, कभी गूगल पे हैव यू ट्राइड ऑन गूगल, यू ट्राइंग टू यू नो सर्च फॉर समथिंग विच इज अ लार्ज यू नो पैराग्राफ एंड देन वॉट हैपन्स? Have you tried searching something on the Google which has a large content? So for example, you get a exception, a strike trace. Sometimes people are habitual of, you know, just copying and pasting in the Google browser to find out what this exception means. Okay. Have you tried something like this? A big paragraph or something putting inside the Google search box? Then what happens? You will see that it will say that there is a certain word limits to be searched and rest of the content is search content is truncated. So it will search just based on the first those number of words. I think 32 or 35 words, something is there. Okay. Clear? Why? Because whatever you search on the Google, you can see that in the URL bar as the four parameter. That means the method is uses what? It's get. And the method used is get, that means there's a limitation to how many characters that you can use. Right? ठीक है, अभी बात क्लियर है समझ में? सो अगर इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बिल्ड अ चैट एप्लीकेशन फॉर एग्जाम्पल बेस्ड ऑन वेब ब्राउजर एंड दैट चैट एप्लीकेशन in that chat application you may typically type a long you know paragraph or something, which method will be more suitable to use? Post, because you don't want your content to be truncated, right? Clear ho gaya? With get you can bookmark the page, with post you cannot bookmark the page. We have discussed this in the previous class as well. Is that clear? Is this clear or not? Batao phir. Kya matlab hota hai isko? Third point ka. कभी देखा है ऐसा एग्जांपल?
जैसे लॉगिन अगर हम करेंगे पोस्ट में अगर वो कुछ मेथड होगा तो वो बुकमार्क कोई ना अगर आएगा तो फिर वो लॉगिन पेज आएगा.
लॉगिन पेज आएगा. एग्जैक्टली व्हाट ही इज सेइंग इज ट्रू. आई मीन इफ यू कैन जस्ट क्विकली सी देन यू नो व्हाट, लेट मी जस्ट रन दिस एप्लीकेशन क्विकली. So what is the resource that we are getting back? index.html, right? So this is a static page. No question of the form parameters, right? We can just bookmark it. Here we don't have the problem, right? But what happens after that, if I say okay, let me say login. Now this is coming along with the form parameters. If I, because the method is get, right, if I just bookmark this home page, say test get done, ठीक है, let me close it back. I am going to the bookmark page. I have skipped the login page, right? I don't need to fill those parameter information, username and the password. Those value are all already the part of the URL bar. And this is the information which is stored. So the hit goes directly to the servlet, which needs the parameter, it is getting it and serving the response back, right? So if you are requesting for a resource, which probably might need a dynamic content, that in that case only you probably need HTML form parameter most of the time, right? So in that case, if the request is get, your form parameter is also saved along with the this URL, and then only you can bookmark it. For example, let me change this index page. From get to post, ठीक है? Let me see if the changes have, you know, view page source. You see the method is post, right? Changes ho gaye, right? Theek hai. Now I'm again saying nahi hai, ab ja raha hu main dynamic page pe, jo pehle jo kiya tha bookmark karke wahi ab karne ja raha hu. Ruk jao, I'm again doing the same thing, right? But the method is post this time. Now what happens, you cannot see the form parameter over here, and you are getting a response. Okay, now I am trying to bookmark this page. Okay, say T1. अच्छा एक मिनट, इसे मैंने क्या कुछ एंट्री में कुछ गलत करी थी क्या? क्या कर रहा हूँ? ये इंडेक्स डॉट एचटीएमएल ही तो सर्व हो रहा है. एक मिनट, अच्छा पोस्ट मेथड के अंदर, ओके पोस्ट, आई हैव नॉट यू नो रिटन द पोस्ट मेथड, ओके द रीजन इज बिकॉज लेट मी डू दिस. This is called as delegation. Already रहता है जब जो code generate होता है, ये रहता है. This is called as delegation. Why we do it? Because instead of copying the whole code that is written the get method, what I am doing is I am just, you know, calling the get method, rather delegating the call to the get method. So whether I change the request type from get or post, I get the same thing. So this is useful when you want to do the same thing from both the methods. Only difference is that you want the benefits of either the credentials to be hidden or the size of the content which is coming at the part of the form parameter to be, you know, not bounded. So you can use post in that case. But the output is same. Case function say? Append is, you know, response.getWriter, you can assume this typically is being, you know, replaced by an object of printWriter, say, just like in the last example we have seen, we have created an out reference variable. And then append is something which is just going to add at the end, okay, of the response, HTML content, okay? Now let's try to see if the changes have taken place or not. Not yet, I think. We have post here. Okay. Login servlet.
Login servlet full HTML
used. That's okay. Somehow it is not taking the changes, otherwise, you know. Just don't. Oh, let me just, something is getting problem, let me remove an ad here. index.html is already in the welcome file list, right? तो तुम लिखो ना लिखो तो क्या फर्क पड़ता है मुझे बताओ. Something it happens. चलो जब तक ये थोड़ा सा रिफ्रेश हो रहा है ठीक है, देखते हैं क्या चक्कर है, जब तक आगे बढ़ते हैं वी विल कम बैक. ठीक है, सो वी हैव सीन दैट फ्रॉम द गेट रिक्वेस्ट वी कैन बुकमार्क द थिंग एंड इफ मेथड इज नॉट मेंशन इन द एचटीएमएल फॉर्म टैग गेट इज द डिफॉल्ट मेथड. सो इन फॉर्म एक्शन एंड व्हेन मेथड इज इक्वल टू इफ यू जस्ट स्किप दैट एट्रीब्यूट इटसेल्फ सो बाय डिफॉल्ट in HTML only it takes get as the default method that is assumed to be requested. ठीक है, लेट मी सी लॉगिन सर्वलेट पॉइंट किसको कर रहा है. सी दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम एक्चुअली. समटाइम यू हैव टू लर्न यू नो हाउ टू डिबग. आई हैव चेंज दिस क्लास एंड आई जस्ट फॉरगेट. ठीक है, आई वॉज मेकिंग चेंजेस इन दिस लॉगिन सर्वलेट क्लास राइट, बट सम टाइम बैक इंस्टेड ऑफ दिस को डॉट इन डॉट जी एच डॉट लॉगिन सर्वलेट आई माइट हैव चेंज लॉगिन सर्वलेट टू लॉगिन सर्वलेट फुल एचटीएमएल डेमोंस्ट्रेट यू इन द लास्ट क्लास राइट. And I didn't remember, right? So I was making changes in the wrong place. This is the problem actually. कर सकते हैं, right? वही कर देते हैं. चलो, तो लैब में भी आपको अक्सर इस तरह की प्रॉब्लम आएगी. तो तरीका ये है कि आप पहले index.html से यू जस्ट गो फॉर द index.html सी व्हाट इज द यूआरएल पैटर्न यू हैव यूज्ड, गो टू द वेब आईएनएफ फोल्डर, गो टू द web.xml फाइल राइट, सी इफ दैट यूआरएल पैटर्न इज मैप टू व्हिच पर्टिकुलर जावा क्लास फाइल एंड देन यू हैव टू क्रॉस चेक दैट whether यू आर मेकिंग चेंजेस एट द राइट प्लेस और नॉट. ठीक है, अब आ रहा है राइट. यू कैन सी फ्रॉम डू गेट मेथड एंड डू पोस्ट मेथड बोथ मैसेजेस आर कमिंग. व्हाई
पोस्ट मेथड में कॉल कर
You have used the delegation in the doPost method. That means you have called a doGet method from the doPost method. So everything that is having in, that is written in the doGet method, that will run. It also prints a message from the doGet method. If you assume that you have copied the content, in that case, of course, you don't need to delegate in that case. ठीक है? या इस चीज को ही इस print जो line हो रही print इसी को हटा दो वहाँ से. ठीक है? It will also have the same thing. So now let me so this is the post method, right? You don't see the form parameters. Let me try to bookmark this page. T1 say already. Let me change it to T2 something. Done. Let me close it. Go to bookmark. Bookmark manager. Yeah. What is that you see? What is the status code? First of all, what is the status code? 500. Internal server error. When you go home, just try to Google what this 500 series of status code actually mean. You will see 500, 501, 502 and so on. There will be a number of such status code. Just try to see what this status code actually mean. They mean a particular type of problem. It is showing you the stack trace. If you have not handled it, then you will see this is stack trace. That is why it is said that you must handle all the probability or the chances of any kind of exception that you may get. There must be a cause. There are going to be different causes for the server error. And one of the causes is that it says you are getting a null pointer exception. What does null pointer exception means? Discuss? Difference null, right? It is pointing to null, right? So what has happened over here? Can you explain in the code? You have bookmarked a URL which is served by the post request, and in the URL bar you don't have the parameters. Those parameters are username and the password. Now you can access those parameters from request object. So when it tries to retrieve those two form parameters, request.get parameter, uname. So there is no such form parameter because that's not coming as a part of the URL. So you get a null over here. The username remains null object. Similarly, you get password assigned as a null reference to this passwd reference variable. Now when you say username dot equals, you replace this username with null and you are trying to invoke a method on a null object, immediately you will get a null pointer exception, right? ठीक है भाई? Even you can see it's saying you are getting the null pointer exception in code.in.gh.login.servlet.doGet.login.servlet.java33. This is the line number 33. यहीं पे आपको मिल रहा है ना? अच्छा now this is really bad if the user sees this exception. Right, because for many reasons. One is that he will be able to know that what are the kind of technology that we are using, internal details about some of the internal details. He can get the hint about the code and all those things, right? Amal functioning of the data, right? And the other thing which is bad is the user doesn't understand this screen. User is habitual to see some error that you can give him as a hint that what might have gone wrong. If I want to handle this particular error, what should I have done? Can someone tell me? It's a runtime exception, right? What it says, I can, you know, put everything in the try and catch block, and if I have get, I'm getting a null pointer exception, then in the catch block I can generate a response page which says probably the parameters are missing. ठीक है, out.println this cache के अंदर generate कर सकते हैं. What else can you do? This is, you know, handling the exception. If I want to use some preventive measure, what can I do? Username is not equals to null and is not equals to null. Sorry. ठीक है, यहां curly braces लगाने की जरूरत नहीं है, because next if statement is just the subsequent line. So this if will execute only if this thing is correct. Otherwise, we can say else. Whatever we, the response page that we want to generate. ठीक है, ये भी एक तरीका हो सकता है. Clear है, समझ में आ रहा है? So you are clear with this difference, yes. The get and the post method. Good. Open a page from your notebook and just quickly write down the answer of these 5 questions. ठीक है, अपने नाम लिख दीजिएगा, that's it. Don't write the questions, just write the answer. One, उसके आगे आपको get या post लिखना है, that's it. Don't forget to write your name, it will be evaluated. बड़ा कर दूं? So the first question is, a user is returning a login name and password. That means you have got a login page and you are filling it username and password. So what the method should be used, get or post? Don't tell me, write it down. Second question is, a user is requesting a new page via a hyperlink. Just a new page like a index.html page. Or in, for example, you must have seen in some tutorial sites, the pages are linked, right? From one topic to another topic, you're just clicking on the topic name and a page is opening. That's a static page, right? The user is requesting a new page via hyperlink. What should be more appropriate thing? A user is requesting a new page via hyperlink. जावा टी पॉइंट वगैरह पे गए होंगे आप लोग ना, तो वहाँ पे क्या होता है, एक इंडेक्स बना होता है लेफ्ट साइड में टॉपिक वाइज, फ्रॉम वन टॉपिक यू कैन क्लिक द लिंक ऑन द अदर टॉपिक एंड देन अ स्टैटिक पेज कम्स द सेम सिचुएशन. I will come around line. Third, a chat room user is sending a written response. What we have just discussed, right? You build a chat application, you may need to type whatever you are discussing in the form of a paragraph or something. Fourth, a user sends a huge data from the server, form to the server, sorry. A user sends a huge data form to the server. That means, just like login page, the form that you have received and you have to fill it and submit, for example, your admission form, right? So that has got huge data, so many form parameters. So what you must use, get or post, okay? Fifth, a user wants to bookmark a page. हो गया, हमने दे दिए. लो भाई मुझे वापस करो, नाम तो लिखा है इसके ऊपर. लो की हेल्प तो नहीं करिए, और किसी का रह गया है? ओके, एम मनुस्वानी इनका पकड़िए, संजीव कुमार इनका पकड़िए, जावेद अहमद, जुनेद अहमद सॉरी इनका पकड़िए, रोमीना लो फटा समी ले लो, अब्दुल रशीद कौस्तुब आप पकड़ो, एन फातिमा इनका आप पकड़ लो, ये दोनों को, कात्यानी देवी इनका आप ले लीजिए, शबी इधर बैठी हैं, इनका पीछे दे दो लास्ट में, उनको नहीं मिला है ना, मिल चुका है, किसको नहीं मिला इधर, आपको नहीं मिला, ओके, अमान खान और किसको नहीं मिला है, अमान आसपास तो नहीं बैठा है ना, ठीक है, मतलब एक दूसरे को इशारे ना कर पाए आप लोग, फराज मसूद आपका पीछे दे दीजिए, रवि कुमार, रवि का उधर कातानी को दे दीजिए, मोहम्मद उस्मान कहाँ बैठे हैं आप, उनको दे दूँ, अच्छा इसके पास कौन बचा अभी, हाँ इधर, गुड, करिश्मा तुम्हें बची हो, टेंशन मत लो, क्या हो दोस्ती ज़्यादा है, अच्छा ठीक है चलो, अब आपको करना क्या है, सिंपली आंसर देखना है, और हर क्वेश्चन पे if that is correct you have to give 1 mark, if that is wrong you have to give 0 mark, total upar likh dena hai simply. So for the first question, a user is returning a login name and password, the method should be post, kar diya. For the second question, a user is requesting a new page via hyperlink, so this is a simple page, right? We probably don't need the form parameter as well, theek hai, why to go for post, theek hai, so this is simply the get. A chat room user is sending a written response. The content could be large, that may exceed the character limit of 255 or whatever the character limit is imposed. So in that case, you must use post. A user sends a huge data form to the server. Tell me get or post. Again post because of the character limit, because form parameters may exceed the character limit. a user wants to bookmark a page. एक दूसरे का मत देखो, अपना चेक करो. Of course, get right. सबके मास्क जल्दी चेक करके मुझे वापस कर दो. टोटल लास्ट में ये देख लो, गेट है फिफ्थ का. चेक कर दिए, टोटल मार्क्स कर दिए. चलो भाई, चार चार, ये भी चार हैं, दो चार चार. मैं क्रॉस चेक करूंगा, बेमानी मत करना. चार चेक नहीं किया, पूरा फाइव सौ लिख दिया उसके ऊपर. तीन चार 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 नंबर, आपके भी चार नंबर लाइए. हाँ, अगर किसी ने कोई बदमाशी करी होगी तो चाय वाले को पकड़ूंगा मैं, बाकी लोग बता देंगे किसके पास किसी कॉपी गई है. ठीक है, लेट हो गया. और किसी की बची तो नहीं है? ठीक है, ओके ओके. सो जस्ट वन लास्ट थिंग वेरी क्विकली, there are several other HTTP methods as well. These are those head, put, delete, trace, option, and connect. So just like if you want to use get in the post method in the form HTML form, you have to use form method is equal to get or post. And similarly, on the server side, you have to provide a support of do get or the do post method. Similarly, if you want to use any of these method, you have to put in the form either head, put, delete, trace, option, or connect. And similarly, you have to provide a do head, do post, do put, do delete, do trace, do option, and do connect method on the servlet, right? Now, why these methods are used is the head asks for the response identical to the one that would correspond to the get request but without the response body. So for the debugging purpose, sometimes the developers, while they are developing the application, they sometimes use this head just to see what is actually going in the head of the HTTP servlet request. So if you use head in the form HTML form as well as you provide a do head method, you will get back the response, right? You have to provide the implementation of it and you can write the response of all the header information. ठीक है, तो वो उसके लिए use हो सकता है. Similarly, put to upload a representation of a specified resource. For example, in many places you have seen the form says upload your picture, upload your file, right? So typically they are using some of the framework which gives you some tag which allows you to do this, right? But behind the scene they are using this HTTP put method to upload a resource. Similarly, you have got a delete resource. So this is something which has to be handled very cautiously. You would not like to provide a support for delete option because that will allow the user to delete something from the server machine, right? Depending it how you implement it. Similarly, trace is something which echoes back the received request. It is again used for the debugging purpose. Options, it could be used to list down all the HTTP methods which are supported. Similarly, connect, it converts the request connection to the transparent TCP IP tunnel for a streaming purpose and other, you know, such similar needs. So as it says, these, you know, HTTP methods are very rarely used. Most of the time you are going to use either get or post. So you don't have to worry about, you know, using these. You have to get focused on get and post, and that will most of the time serve your work. ठीक है? Just to know, there are other six methods as well. So in total, there are eight HTTP methods that I mentioned over here. ठीक है?